It is difficult to overstate the importance of Excel proficiency if you want to become a financial analyst. In this video, I'll be happy to share with you my tested and proven roadmap on how to learn Excel for financial analysis easy and fast. My name is Ned, and I've worked as a financial analyst in companies like Coca-Cola and PwC. I've also created some of the most popular Excel courses online. Hopefully, my advice will be useful to you and will help you learn Excel and land your dream job. Please hit the like button of this video and subscribe to our channel. This means the world to me. Okay, ready to become an Excel pro? Let's dive right in. In week one of your studies, you need to grasp the fundamentals: how to cut, copy, and paste, how to create and edit Excel functions, how to perform basic data entry tasks, and how to use most cell formatting tools available in Excel. All of this can be learned in a few days if you follow the right program. A crucial mistake some users make is that they don't learn how to take advantage of Excel's shortcuts. Don't be one of them. It is important to start learning Excel shortcuts right away. This will pay off greatly over time. Trust me, you'll get used to the most popular keyboard combinations, which will make you much faster than the average user. And when you're faster, you have more time to revise for mistakes and think about your analysis. In your second week, you'll continue by learning important Excel functions and pivot table fundamentals. All financial analysts need to be able to look up data using VLOOKUP, XLOOKUP, or index and match. Moreover, they need to know how to work with logical functions such as COUNTIF, COUNTIFS, SUMIF, and SUMIFS. After all, financial reports can't be created without looking up, counting, and summing data, right? Don't just learn how SUMIF and SUMIFS functions work. Instead, try to work on exercises that ask you to anchor cell references and reuse the functions you've created for an entire table. Again, this is difficult to do at first, but will speed up all your future work. More than 12 years ago, when I got a position as a financial analyst intern, I didn't like pivot tables and always preferred functions. But over time, I started to appreciate pivot tables. They tend to protect you from beginner mistakes, such as cell references pointing the wrong way or cells containing the wrong formula. Very frequently, financial analysts have to work with tabular data containing financials and different levels of breakdowns. Pivot tables are the go-to tool you'll need to explore financial data. So, at the end of week two of your Excel training, you'll know when and how to create lookup and logical Excel functions, and how to insert a basic pivot table. Not bad, right? If you like how all of this sounds, I'll be happy to welcome you in the 365 Financial Analyst Program. We have created courses that will provide you the preparation I wish I had when I started working as a financial analyst. Learn Excel for financial analysis in a practical way, using real-world examples that will teach you precisely what you need to know to land an internship or a full-time job as an entry-level financial analyst. Make sure you check out the link in the description. Now that you know Excel's basic features and how to work with functions and pivot tables, it is time to add several key tools to your arsenal. In week three, you can focus on necessary mechanics, such as text to columns, remove duplicates, freeze panes, find and replace, fast scrolling, creating a drop-down list, sorting, conditional formatting, cell formatting, and more. It is essential to know how these features work and where you can use them. Over time, I've noticed that one of Excel's tools that I use most frequently is filtering. I use it to review what is in my data. I use filtering to slide and dice the data, and even use it to find mistakes. All of this means that knowing how to work with spreadsheet software is as much about knowing how features work, but also accumulating practical experience of how you can use these features in the working process. As usual, it is best if you're able to incorporate all these new concepts in one big, comprehensive, real-world example. This will reinforce significantly what you have learned and will help you see the big picture. From my experience, the best exercise for aspiring financial analysts is to build a P&L from raw data extraction. And this is precisely what I'd advise you to do in week four. The Build a P&L from Scratch exercise in my Excel course asks students to filter data, organize a database, use lookup functions, leverage SUMIF, map financial data based on criteria, find mistakes with COUNTIF, format data professionally. This basically shows you how to use your newly acquired knowledge to solve a real-world problem. and you'll be able to do that. I don't have a doubt in my mind. Finally, in week 5, you can spend some time to learn how to create different types of Excel charts and how to format them professionally. In general, if you want to make a good impression with your work, you need to learn how to apply a professional layout to your Excel spreadsheets. Okay, great. This is my roadmap that will help you become good at Excel in just 5 weeks, assuming you'll spend 2 hours per day watching tutorials and solving practical tasks. One last thing, if you're struggling to find practical tasks, you can visit 365financialanalyst.com, where we have a dedicated projects section with real-world practical tasks. Thanks so much for staying until the end of this video. I'm sure you'll do great. You've got this.